Oh yeah, Suleiman, Mr. Ryder. He goes, guys. Everybody, right here.
In the history of boxing, who does he remind you?
The greatest fighters.
True champion right here. This is what they want the rebels. This is I'm the real champion. Like I said, they're gonna keep this belt warm for me. Because I like my peach cobbler warm. You know? And I'm gonna come and get it after they keep it.
Can you bring that belt up
Deontay,
to your chins all the way?
Unblemished and all of them by knockout.
Over here, Mr. Sullivan.
When you go into the ring, is that what's going through your mind to get that person out of there as quick as possible, or do you take it as it comes?
Well, I always use the term as I don't get paid for overtime. So, you know, right there, that's self-explanatory right there. I go in and try to get the job done and get out. You know, at the end of the day, people don't want to come and see a 12-round fight. They don't want to see that. You know, it's good you have a fast fighter and, you know, show the skills out. But people, at the end of the day, they want to see knockouts. And what Deontay's been doing, he's
doing all knockouts.
All knockouts. All night. That's what they want to see. That's what the big buzz, that's what the buzz been about. You know, even though it may go short rounds or may not go past the fourth round, but at the end of the day, they're looking at the highlights, they're looking at the knockouts, and that's what they want.
You think right we may see a knockout in this one here?
Here you go, Suleiman, Deontay.
When they talking, you may see it.
Suleiman, right here,
but,
right here.
You know,
right here.
Like I said, it's different between when you're in the midst of everything right now and when it's time to really fight and get up in that ring when the lights come action, when you just really feel that. Because it's a
yourself.
Whole other.
And he's a true exemplary fighter outside the ring as well. Very proud of you.
Hey, Bronze, what you make of them saying you don't deserve it?
I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow.
Take care.
So what do you think would be a more difficult fight, Stibern or Ariola? How would you fight each other
it's
differently?
Equal. Because both will have. The only thing is different between Stibern and Ariola for me is that Stibern, he have a style like a big man. He like to sit on the outside. He's not, as far as him, you should, guys, his height, his size, you mostly see kind of trying to pressure a fighter and stuff like that. He's not a pressure type of fighter, which Chris Ariola is a pressure fighter, but either or for me. This is like they just giving me the belt. You know, this is true for me. So, you know, either or, man, maybe best man win.
You don't see any difference between the two of them as far as, like, say, you putting each one out in a knockout? I mean, do you see yourself knocking both those guys out?
Definitely. How do you knock both of them out? You know?
Would you do it earlier? Would it take a while? Who would be?
Under four.
Bro, what would you make of them?
Like I've been
doing. You deserve it, man.
Well, you know, yeah, everybody has their own opinion. You know, I feel the same way about his people. I don't feel Mr. Byrne has done nothing.
Let me get a shot with you and Dan Goosen, okay?
Yeah, definitely.
Mr. Goosen.
I don't feel he's done Rodney. Nothing to deserve a shot. Only person
Dan.
He's really beat was Chris Ariola. He got knocked out by Demetrius King. Yeah. He got pounded.
Let me get a shot with Dan and
by my
Mr. Goosen. Get over here.
He just won in the last round. But you know, other than that,
you got two shots.
Yes, sir.
Will Oscar get upset or is it Richard?
Oh, no, man. See, they, you know, what they got going on, they ain't got nothing to do with it.
Mr. Suleiman. Mr.